Introduction. If one is to realistically entertain the notion of interstellar exploration in timeframes of a human lifespan, a dramatic shift in the traditional approach to spacecraft propulsion is necessary. It has been known and well tested since the time of Einstein that all matter is restricted to motion at sublight velocities, that is, much lower than 3 times 10 in the power of 8 meters per second, the speed of light, or c, and that as matter approaches the speed of light, its mass asymptotically approaches infinity. This mass increase ensures that an infinite amount of energy would be necessary to travel at the speed of light, and thus this speed is impossible to reach and represents an absolute speed limit to all matter traveling through spacetime. Even if an engine were designed that could propel a spacecraft to an appreciable fraction of light speed, travel to even the closest stars would take many decades in the frame of reference of an observer on Earth. Although these lengthy transit times would not make interstellar exploration impossible, they would certainly dampen the enthusiasm of governments or private individuals funding these missions. After all, a mission whose success is perhaps a century away would be difficult to justify. In recent years, however, physicists have discovered two loopholes to Einstein's ultimate speed limit. The Einstein-Rosen bridge, commonly referred to as the wormhole, and the hyperdrive. Fundamentally, both ideas involve manipulation of spacetime itself in some exotic way that allows for faster-than-light FTL travel. Essentially, the wormhole involves connecting two potentially distant regions of space by a topological shortcut. Theoretically, one would enter the wormhole and instantaneously be transported to the exit located in a distant region of space. Although no observational evidence of wormholes exists, theoretically they can exist as a valid solution to general relativity. The hyperdrive, the main focus of this course, involves local manipulation of the fabric of space in the immediate vicinity of a spacecraft. The basic idea is to create an asymmetric bubble of space that is contracting in front of the spacecraft while expanding behind it. Using this form of locomotion, the space itself facilitates the relative motion of the spacecraft. The most attractive feature of the hyperdrive is that the theory of relativity places no known restrictions on the motion of space itself, thus allowing for a convenient circumvention of the speed of light barrier. An advanced aerospace platform incorporating hyperdrive technology would profoundly alter the capacity to explore and potentially to colonize the universe. Because a hyperdrive is not limited by the speed of light, one can only guess the top speeds such a technology might be capable of achieving. For the sake of argument, let's consider the duration of trips taken by a spacecraft capable of 100°C. For an array of exotic destinations of possible interest. As this table shows, trips to the planets within our solar system would take hours rather than years, and journeys to local star systems would be measured in weeks rather than hundreds of thousands of years. Until recently, the rep drive was a concept reserved for science fiction. However, a 1994 paper by Miguel Alcubierre placed the idea on a more solid theoretical footing. Alcubierre demonstrated that a specific Lorentzian manifold could be chosen that exhibited bubble-like features reminiscent of the rep drive from the popular Star Trek television series. The bubble allowed for the surrounding spacetime to move at FTL speeds, and the inhabitants of the bubble would feel no acceleration effects because the spacetime itself would be in motion instead of the spacecraft and its inhabitants. A number of papers have emerged in recent years that build on this original idea. However, these papers do not typically address how one might actually create the necessary space-time bubble. Our own research directly addresses this question from a new and unique perspective and introduces a novel paradigm shift in the field of rep drive studies.